As a young man, I always had the privilege of flying on aircrafts, and my first experience with aviation, I was 8 years old. I had the privilege of being on a chartered flight from Lusaka to Senanga, which is in the western part of Zambia. And what amazed me about that experience is these pilots we're flying with had never been to Zambia for a start, and they'd never been to the western part of Zambia. So I was strongly drawn to the fact that how do these pilots know where they're going? They've never been to this airport before, but they know where they're going. So that's when my affinity with aviation began. In order for you to be successful, you must be doing what you really enjoy and love. So I started my initial training, which they call a private pilot's license, which is like your first stage of flying, at a place called ZASTI, Zambia Air Services Training Institute, here in Zambia. And it was whilst at ZASTI that I met the love of my life, who's currently my wife now. And she was also a pilot student, and safe to say, we ended up getting married. And it's an interesting combination of having two pilots in the house, and we've been married for 12 years, and we have four beautiful daughters. In 2003, I graduated with my initial commercial pilot's license. I would say that's when my flying career actually began moving on to another level. And I was then employed by Zambian Airways here in Zambia. And I flew with them for about 3 to 4 years. In 2007, I left them and I went and joined a company in the Middle East. And then from the job in West Africa, ended up at ProFlight. I started off as a first officer on the flagship of the company, the Sierra J100, the popular jet, which passengers love and enjoy. So after the 2 years as a first officer, actually I was first officer for about a year. Thereafter, I got promoted to captain. Then I took on the role of a fleet manager on the jet, basically a captain who's in charge of the going-ons on that fleet. So basically, the fleet manager would report to the chief pilot, and obviously the chief pilot reports to the director of flight operations. So I served on that position for about 3 months. Then the opening did come up for the position of chief pilot. Obviously, in the past, I've served as a chief pilot before in different companies. But in Zambia, it would have been different because basically, personally, I had the impression that to be a chief pilot in this country, one, you had to have lots of white or grey hair on your head, and two, you have to have been flying for at least 30 years. But looking at my career, I've only been flying for 14 years, going to 15 years now, and very few white or grey hairs on my head. So I thought that's not part of the required elements of being a chief pilot. But, you know, having the ambition and the drive in life to move on to another stage, I applied for the job, went through the whole process, and I was surprised when I was offered the position, you know. And it's such a privilege and great honor to be in this position because I serve a fine group of pilots, you know. I'm the standard setter when it comes to the pilots, and it's a very easy job for me because the pilots that I represent are very professional. They know what is required of them, so it makes my job a lot easier.